Jewish God's name is Yahweh, formed from four letters, in Greek known as a tetragrammaton, the four letters. The delivery of this name from God to humans appears in Exodus 3:13 to 15. Let's read. Moses said to God, "When I come to the Israelites and say to them, 'The God of your father has sent me to you,' and they ask me, 'What is his name?' what shall I say to them?" And God said to Moses, "Ehyeh asher ehyeh, I am that I am, or I am who I am." He continued, "Thus shall you say to the Israelites, Ehyeh, I am, sent me to you." And God said further to Moses, "Thus shall you speak to the Israelites, Yahweh, the Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, has sent me to you. This shall be my name forever, this my appellation for all eternity." As you can see, in the Bible, the God of Jews and Christians, as they still read it in the Bible, declares that this is his name, and this is what they are to call him. The Bible also uses this name numerous times. The problem is that these four letters, Yahweh, don't exactly give people the explanation on how to pronounce the name, and signs were only added later to these words, and due to one of the Ten Commandments that goes, "You shall not take the name of the Lord, your God, in vain." Jews were usually anxious about the usage of God's name altogether, and replaced the name in prayers and in reading the Bible with Adonai. So Adonai, Lord, or the Lord, instead of Yahweh. Even in one of the most important Jewish prayers, the Shema Yisrael, Yahweh is replaced with Adonai. The prayer goes, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord is one." In Hebrew, Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. When in reality, the text reads, Shema Yisrael, Yahweh Eloheinu, Yahweh Echad. This is how sacred the name is. Now, what is Islam's position on all this? The Quran never mentions Yahweh. The Hadith never mention Yahweh. No Islamic source ever mentions Yahweh. The Quran introduces Allah. Muhammad speaks of Allah. Muslims know their God as Allah. How could it be that such a sacred thing, the name of God, that he, according to millennia-old Jewish and Christian belief, told his people to use, is not mentioned in Islam at all? It doesn't appear anywhere in Islam. Instead, mosques have Allah written all over them, while mosques also have Muhammad written all over them, which is something I'll certainly come to in another video. Aside from this very important point, that the Christian and Jewish God's name is not the Islamic God's name at all, there are so many other factors that would make us conclude that Islam just appropriates the biblical Abrahamic God, and it takes aspects of the religion, but it doesn't represent the same religion or the same God. The Ten Commandments, for example, that we mentioned earlier, that are the fundaments of worship and of ethics in Judaism and in Christianity, are entirely missing in Islam. It would be expected that Islam either mentions Yahweh and accepts this as Allah's name, or Islam never mentions Yahweh and rejects this as Allah's name. The second option is true, or that's what Muslims believe. And here we come to a huge problem for Islam. It is very common among religious groups.
One of David Wood's boyfriends, apostate prophet, is basically stating that the name of Yahweh is the name of God, and the author of the Quran, who he thinks is Muhammad, didn't know about Yahweh. So when the Quran talks about the name of God, he gets it wrong, because the name of God was Yahweh, not Allah. Thus, the author of the Quran didn't know what the Jews and Christians were calling God before, you know, the revelation of the Quran. So this is basically the gist of his argument. So I'm going to be refuting that argument right now. The first point I want to make is, after doing some research on this issue, because I didn't know about this issue until, I don't know, a few years ago. Like, I think back in 2012, I did some serious research into this issue of Yahweh being the name of God. And what I found out back then is that the issue is that Yahweh is not the name of God to begin with. In fact, Yahweh was never the name of God to begin with. So all you got to do is you have to go to biblical commentaries. And according to biblical scholars, not liberals or atheists, Yahweh means he is, according to the New Jerusalem Bible, page 85, notes on Exodus chapter 3, verse 14. If Yahweh means he is, how can that be the name of God? So Yahweh definitely is not the name of God, because according to biblical scholars, you know, Judeo-Christian biblical scholars, they say that Yahweh means he is. The third point is that the Greek New Testament manuscripts never mention Yahweh. It is replaced by the Greek word kurios, meaning Lord. So Christianity fails that same exact test of Yahweh, of the tetrametrogram or Yahweh's mention. Of course, apostate prophet never mentions this in his video or his videos, since, you know, he made two videos about this topic. There could be two reasons for this. One is because he is either ignorant, or two, he's lying, or both. But given what I know about apostate prophet, he's probably ignorant and lying, so it's probably both. It's probably both cases. According to the fourth point I want to make is, according to the Old Testament, God had many names. If you read Genesis chapter 1 verse 1 in Hebrew, it says, in the beginning, Elohim created the heavens and the earth. So God's name, according to Genesis chapter 1 verse 1 in Hebrew, was Elohim, not Yahweh. Some of it being the Hebrew words Elohim, Elohah, Adonai, etc. This was all before Exodus chapter 3 verse 14. Again, read the Hebrew of Genesis 1 and so on. Another point is, there's a really good book that came out, I think, back in 2016 or something like that, called The Invention of God by Thomas Rohr. Now, this person actually proves that Yahweh was actually a pre-Mosaic pagan deity, from an ancient tribe called Midian. So basically, Yahweh was a pagan deity who, get this, actually had a wife. So Yahweh was a name of a pagan god, that had nothing to do with the Jews or the Israelites. In fact, the biblical author stole that name Yahweh, as you can see in the map there, when they left Egypt and went to the Midian. They took that name Yahweh from a local pagan god, Yahoo. Yahoo eventually became the name Yahweh. So Yahweh is the name of a pagan god from outside of Israel, outside the Israeli tribe. Conclusion here is that Yahweh is not the name of God. In fact, it is taken from pagan sources, as you've seen in the map and from the book I just shown on the screen. Thus, Islam is correct in not saying that name Yahweh. So Yahweh definitely is not the name of God. Apostate prophet is wrong yet again.